So hey my YouTubers and everyone in the world, today is December the 12th. The time is now 4:18 p.m. So today was a beautiful Wednesday all day. I'm just so thankful that the work part of the day is officially over. But moving forward, I'm going to have a story time for you guys today, and I'm going to talk to you about how to take positive criticism, how to take criticism just in a positive way from people. Now, you know, as you guys know, I ended up straightening my hair, so a lot of people at my job were really, really shocked because they've never seen my hair out, like, ever. You know, I've been there 2 years, and I've never had my hair like this ever. This is officially the first time, and I miss my curls already, but, you know, sometimes you just gotta let your hair breathe, you know? But moving forward, you know, so I went to the job today, and, you know, you're going to have people that's going to be happy for you. Oh, you look nice. You look beautiful. I like your hair. And as you guys know, I do work in a school, so a lot of the kids were, you know, giving me compliments. They said they love my new hairstyle. It's very nice. It fits me. You look beautiful. You know, all the positive stuff. But then, of course, you know you're going to have people who just, you know, who's just hating, who just got, you know, always got shit to say. So, you know, this guy comes up to me at the job and he's like, you know, he could have gave me a compliment and said, hey, your hairstyle is nice, and just kind of called it a day. But of course, you know that sometimes people just have to try to call themselves raining on your parade. And I'm going to tell you guys how to deal with that situation moving forward as well. But, you know, he came one insult after another. And I'm like, I'm thinking to myself, and I'm like, wow, he's really coming at me type hard. And I had to think about it, like, sometimes when people are jealous, instead of giving you a compliment, they'd rather, you know, try to put you down and rain on your parade and make you feel bad. He's like, oh my God, you know, you look like you stressed or something, or you look like you losing weight or something. See, this is my thing. Whether I'm stressed in my own personal life, or whether I'm, you know, exercising more and just getting my body in tip-top shape, or whatever the case may be, the point is, if you don't have anything positive to say, then why say anything at all? You understand? And that's what kind of baffled me, because this is a man older than I am. So you should know better. So at the end of the day, it's like, You see how people really feel, you know, especially in times like this. All he had to do, he ain't even have to say nothing. But if he wanted to say something, it could have been something positive. You understand? Something that's uplifting, something that's nice. Oh, well, Mr. Day, you look nice today. Thank you very much. I mean, it's just that simple. But sometimes people want to rain on your parade. And I'm telling you, do not let it happen. And I had to put him in his place. I said, look, it's, you know, if you like big women, cool, but I'm naturally like slim thick. That's what I would call myself. So at the end of the day, let me be myself. Don't compare me to these other women out here. Don't compare no women to another woman. No women like that. And men don't like that either. That's like me going up to a man and saying, oh, you know, his abs are bigger than yours. Your body is the way it is. His body is the way it is. Why is it that I have to be doing this or doing that? So it kind of baffled me, and I had to. When he said, you know, it was one insult after another, and I was thinking to myself, I said, you know what? He's really trying to bring my spirit down right now, and I seen it, you know, in action. And I said, okay, cool, so I see where this is going. So I had to, like, you know, pull him to the side and put him in his place. First of all, I don't even understand why you looking at my body. You understand? My whole thing is, even if you looking at it, you don't have to make it obvious to me or anybody else. And if you don't have anything positive to say, then maybe it's best that you keep your negative comments to yourself. And that's exactly, you know, what I had to tell him, because I didn't appreciate the insults, you know, one after the other. It's like, dude, this is who I am. If you don't like what you see, that's perfectly fine. On to the next. You understand? But you don't come up to me and try to rain on my parade because I did something nice for myself. What I did for me had nothing to do with nobody else. It was time for me to let my hair out and let it breathe. And it shouldn't have been a problem that I did that. But, you know, like I said before, sometimes people just want to rain on your parade. They want you to feel like you're doing something wrong. I'm not doing anything wrong. My body is just fine the way it is, the way God made it to be. And at the end of the day, my whole thing is, why did you feel like you need to come and tell me something like that? You know, so I had to really set him straight. I really had to, because you know what? My thing is, you're not going to insult me and think that you're going to walk away scot-free like, oh yeah, well, Because, see, if you don't put people in a place immediately, see, what they do is they get too comfortable. Now, we work together, so there should be no reason why you was even comfortable enough to feel like you could come up to me and have anything to say about anything not pertaining to work. So, you know, I really, moving forward, I'm going to be a lot more cautious when it comes to dealing with them guys at the job and, you know, just people in general. And I keep it professional, but, you know, once in a while, I like to, you know, laugh a little bit. And, you know, I don't want to seem antisocial, so I like to say hi to people and have conversations here and there. But I'm going to be very mindful of the conversations I have with people. And, you know, I'm going to be mindful of who I play with, too. Like, just even joking-wise and stuff. Because sometimes people get so comfortable and they take it to the next level. And then you got to set them straight immediately. Because if you don't, at the end of the day, they're going to do it again. And it's not going to stop. So, see, he knows now. You understand? I don't care if you're older than me or not. You're going to respect me just like I respect you. And that's what everything is about in life. But moving forward, when people come up to you with negative criticism and stuff, like, you can take it in a positive way and make it your own. Like, if a person is trying to make you feel bad about something and you feel like it's something that you can change in your life, now you know that this person obviously wants to hurt your feelings. We already got that. But you don't have to let this person get under your skin like that. See, the key to it is you could take that negative criticism from this negative person and turn it into something positive and just make it your own and continue to work on yourself. Because that's all you could do. You can't help the fact that some people are very ignorant and they just act like they don't have common sense and they're not respectful at times. They're extremely disrespectful. And that's who people are, certain people. You know, but when a person is trying to come at you and they're trying to make you feel bad, turn it into something positive immediately and keep it pushing. You letting them know, look, I'm above you and I'm above this situation and this is how I'm going to handle this and I'm going to walk away and leave you standing there looking stupid. You understand? So, I mean, that's just how it is sometimes. And you just got to be like that, man, because sometimes people will see you did something nice for yourself and they take it so personal that they want you to feel bad. But when they do something nice for themselves, you're like, oh, okay, you look nice today. There's no problem with saying that. But some people would rather roll their eyes and, you know, stomp their feet and suck their teeth than to sit there and give you a compliment and say you look nice. You know, so I mean, I just want you guys to know that sometimes people will trying to rain on your parade, but just don't let it get under your skin, you know. And if it's something negative, you can easily turn it into something positive with just the thought of it, you know. Don't even take it in a negative way. Sometimes people can't help themselves but be negative because they got so much bullshit going on in their own life, you know, so they want to come to the job and just start shit there. But don't even let that get to you. Because it's not that serious and it's not, you know, look where it's coming from. Sometimes you got to look at the person who's talking shit and be like, oh, okay, I see why, you know? So, yeah, I just had to vlog about that real quick, man. And just when you get people that's trying to rain on your parade or whatever the case may be, just, you know what? When life gives you lemons, we make lemonade. That's how we do this. So even though it's something negative, you can definitely turn it into a positive situation just that fast. But if you have to stand up for yourself, then you stand up for yourself and you let people know. You know, because you can't have people out here disrespecting you thinking that it's okay. If you feel some type of way about something, then you have to speak up about it. But, you know, that was just a quick vlog. I just had to, you know, let you guys know that, you know, that's how my day was and stuff. Moving forward, it's 7 days left until vacation and the countdown continues. But, like I always say, guys, like, comment, subscribe, and share. And, of course, visit my website at shoploveronline.com. Until next time, guys, let's turn these negative situations into positive situations. Peace.